In this video, we're going to give the photograph on the left here of the sunflowers a thick paint or impasto treatment, and we're going to try and make the paint look as if it had been, at least in part, applied with a palette knife, and gives that sort of smeary look. So you can see some of the effects here and here, and also to see something of the paint thickness. We're going to be using some mixer tool brush tool presets. That's a bit of a mouthful. Which are, of course, were introduced in CS5. And we're also going to be using a Wacom digital tablet and pen tool. And you definitely do need a tablet and pen tool for this exercise. It would be extremely difficult, if possible at all, with a mouse. But let's get started. Close down the final image that we had on just now. And I've got the starter JPEG here. And the first thing we're going to do is to load our mixer brush tool presets. First thing is to make sure that in the toolbox you've got the mixer brush tool selected here, and then come up to the tool preset picker. You may already have some tools in there, that's fine. Use the flyout menu, come down to load tool presets, and then navigate to your disk or the download and load the DC palette knife tool preset CS6 and click load. Then you can see that we've got 5 brushes, tool presets loaded, ready for action. Now we're going to create the layer that we're actually going to be cloning from with our mixer brush tools. And to do that, let's duplicate the background layer, and let's call this 1, then 8 to 2 with source. Click OK. The 1 is simply so we can remember the order of the layers, these various layers as we work on them, and the 8 to 2 denote the angle of the diagonal slant or orientation of the brush. Now, duplicate this layer again and call this one source and click OK. Then on the source layer, with the source layer active, reduce the opacity of that layer to about 14%. Now let's create the layer we're actually going to paint into, and that layer is going to be added just below the source layer. So come down here, second from the right, the icon at the bottom of the layer panel, and got create new layer. Let's just drag it down to there. So we want it just below the source layer, and we can close off, make invisible those two layers, and so we're going to be painting into this layer here with our brushes. Let's just give our black layer a name so we can identify it later. Come out to layer rename, call it 1 8 2 2 with source. And now we can actually start painting. We're going to use here the first brush, which is the 182 straight knife 97. Now, a couple of tips here. If you find that the paint is going on a bit too thick and the brush is dragging, you can either reduce or both reduce the size of the brush a bit and increase the magnification that you're working at, and that will give quite a good effect. Now, what we're seeing here, this is the paint actually coming from our source layer, which is above our working layer. You can tell that because both the other layers are invisible. And of course, we can just see a small amount, about 14% in fact, of the source layer in the image as we create it, because we're seeing it through that. So if I take that out, that's just paint. And this is a very thick and highly mixed mixer brush setting that you're seeing here. Now, all these, of course, all the brush strokes here are in the same orientation, and in the next brush that we use, we will change that orientation to come in the other direction at a 10 to 4 setting, which will again help to delineate in a sort of palette-like way some of the forms, particularly in the petals that we're seeing at the moment. Right, so I'm going to get on with that, and I'll come back to that when I finish this layer. So, there is that layer finished. Let me just switch off the source. Now you can actually see that that is the way the paint has been applied. You can see that lots of straight, hard edges there, which are quite like a palette knife. Now, just incidentally, when you're doing, make sure you haven't got any empty, blank areas where you're seeing nothing, so to speak. You need to cover the, like that, for example. You need to cover the entire image. So now we're going to make our next layer for painting. So we're going to duplicate that and call the next one 2 10 2 4 with source, and click OK. Now we're going to paint into this layer with the same brush but used at a different orientation. So let's just switch off the layer below the 2 10 to 4 layer, and with them again come up to our mixer brush preset tools and come down to number 2 brush, the 10 to 4 straight knife. Now here I'm just going to drop this back because of the resolution. I think it needs to be a bit smaller. That 78 is fine. Wait, just find a comfortable size for your brush to operate at. And here, what we're really looking at here, make sure you've got the source active. If the source isn't active when you paint, all you're doing is mixing around the pixels already in the image. Let me show you. When you do that, there is no new paint being added. It is just simply mixing what's already on the layer. So make sure that's, so you can see it's back now. Now we've got new paint. So here, you don't need to paint over the whole image. We just want to add some strokes with a different orientation, and this will also help the flowers to read well. You can see what's going on here, that sort of effect. So we want to try and retain some of the hard edges, which are so characteristic of a larger palette knife. So you can see, let me just so you can see what's going on. If you can work at a larger size, that's fine on the screen. The thing is to enjoy the application of the paint. See here. This is an expressive style, so it doesn't matter at all if the detail's not all there, as long as the images are clear enough to make out. Okay, let's come back to this when I've finished this layer. Let's finish that layer. You can see that, let me switch off the source. The marks are quite distinctive, and they're not like the sort of marks you get made with a brush. So, now we're going to add some sort of stuttering, comby effects of the sort you can also get with paint build-up on a palette knife. So let's duplicate this layer and call this one 3 coma no source. It's just to remind ourselves, and click OK. And here we're going to not switch on the source. So that means we're going to be, with our next brush, just moving around the actual pixels already painted. And the brush we're going to use, that come up again here to use our 3 GUI Coma 100. I'm going to make that a little bit smaller. So that's a fraction. Now here, what we just want to use this here and there. Let me just see if I can increase that a bit. We're not imitating brush strokes here, but the sort of swirliness that you can get with a palette knife. And it adds variety and dynamism to the image. It makes it more interesting to look at. But remember, so here we haven't got any source image being played in. We're just adding here and there some of these strokes. Let's just come down here. Okay, I'll come down and finish this and then we'll come back to it. So we finished the brushing with that brush, and you can see here now we've got some combing effects. I can also see one or two bits of missing paint. I'll have to attend to those. But here and there, which is all you need, like that. It's just the odd suggestion of some scraped paint. Now, we're going to add some more straight palette knife now, but this time a horizontal knife. And again, just use it here and there, just to straighten out the odd petal or add a bit more correct orientation to some flowers. We don't need to use it a lot, but we do need to use it. We're going to use it with the source this time, I should say, which will add back detail from the original image. So let's duplicate our working layer and call the new one 4923 with source, so we remember. Click OK. Now make sure that we've got the source layer active and come up here to our preset picker, come down to 4923. You can see that this is pretty much horizontal. I want to do a little bit of work here. You can see what you're doing by just simply turning off the source. Again, it adds just a bit of variety, and we can use it just to fashion a little bit more some of the petals. This is not to make them all rounded, because that will defeat the object of having a palette knife effect. But it's just here and there. It's quite nice to have some horizontal brush strokes, basically. See, we've got a kind of sliding effect there. We're just adding them in as we feel like it. Again, don't overdo them. We don't need the image covered in them at all. It's just to add some variety. Okay, let's come back to this when I finish this layer. There we've got that brush layer completed, and the effect is, let me just turn off the source. The effect is quite subtle. We haven't used a lot of it, and we've kept lots of angularity and in the strokes that you can see applied. They've just been added in odd places, like there, to just straighten out some of the petals. It mustn't be overused. The same goes for all the brushes. Don't overuse any particular brush. And now we're going to add some paint thickness. To do that, let's duplicate the working layer twice and again, and call the upper of the two new layers 4 Emboss and click OK. Then close down the original 4 9 to 3 layer, so you're just looking at the two new layers, and on the upper of them, the 4 Emboss layer, come up to Filter, down to Stylize, Emboss, and you want these numbers, -149, height 11, and amount 108, and click OK. Next, go to Image, Adjustments, sorry, we need to make this active. Go to Image, Adjustments, then down to Desaturate and click Yes. Now, to sharpen this up, come to Filter, down to Other, High Pass, and we want a radius of around about 55, and then click OK. And now make sure that no other layers are active, and change the blend mode of this to overlay, and now merge the layers. To come up to layer, down to merge visible, click OK. So that's our first thickness applied, which we'll add to later. Now I just want to sort out a bit these flowers, these bright yellow greeny flowers here, and we're going to use our final brush for that. To do that, create a new layer above our 4 Emboss and call this one go up to layer, and rename it 5 small round with source, and close the well, actually keep that one active in fact, and then make active again the source layer, which should again be set to an opacity of 14%. So you're painting now onto a blank layer. So we've got our blank layer active, and come up to make sure again the mixer brush is active. Find one, 5 small round top 955. And here I'm just going to use this. Again, we're picking up detail from our source layer. I'm just going to use this, to, as I said, to fix these flowers a bit, and also to fix any gaps I've left anywhere, if we, where the paint hasn't been applied properly. So here we are. Just although this goes rather against the idea of a palette knife, it's a guess to give a bit of variety. I mean, one can imagine this being done with a very small palette knife. And also, again, you're being selective. I think here I just want to make the centerpieces of these flowers a little bit more clear. Okay, we'll come back to this in a moment. So that's as much as I need to do, I think, with that brush. Again, the effect is quite subtle. Don't overuse it. Now we're going to add separately some paint thickness for that. So close off the 4 Emboss, so now you can see actually what the paint we've added, and duplicate that twice, and duplicate that one, and call this one 5 Emboss and click OK. Again, we're just looking at these two, and with the 5 Emboss layer active, come up to Filter, down to Stylize, Emboss. We're using the same settings as before, 11 and 108, click OK. Then as before, we're going to come up to Image, Adjustments, Desaturate, and then to add some sharpening, down to Other, Filter, Other, High Pass, and a radius of 55, and click OK. Then change the blend mode to overlay and merge visible. So we don't layer, come down to the bottom, merge visible, make sure that no other layers are active or visible, click OK. And then when we see that with 4 emboss, you can see that we've added another element of thickness to the paint application. Now I want to make a composite of this image, and to do that we're going to duplicate our 2 emboss layers and merge them as our composite. So first of all, with our the active 5 emboss, duplicate that one and just call it 5, click OK, and the 4 emboss layer, active, duplicate, call it 4, click OK, then drag that up below the 5 and close down the 5 emboss and 4, well, it's not active, emboss layers. So the 2 active layers you've got are 5 and 4. Come up to Layer, Merge Visible, and then let's call this, make this, so let rename, and call this Composite. We need to add some more delineation to the thickness effect, and we'll do that using the photocopy filter. Make sure just before we start that in your color picker black is selected, and then on composite duplicate that and call that photocopy, click OK, and then come up to filter, sketch, photocopy. Take a little moment to load. And if I just reduce the size of that, you can see the sort of effect it's doing. What it will do is just add a little bit of shadow to the lines. Now, the settings we want are Detail 1 and Darkness 41. And click OK. And then change the blend mode for that layer to multiply and bring down the opacity for that layer to somewhere around 50, let's call it 58, something like that. So that's added the shadow effect, which you can see is quite striking to our composite layer, and it just makes some of the brush strokes stand proud of the flat canvas layer surface. But in case you have any more tweaks that you want to do, you may not, but in case you do, duplicate the composite layer and call this one Tweaks, click OK, then close the photocopy layer and open up the source layer, and here I'm just going to again with the small round brush, or mixer brush tool I should say, just going to pick out some of these again. And what I'm doing here is I'm just wanting to establish them a bit more as blocks of colour. You may not have anything at all that you want to tweak, but it's a good idea to have an opportunity just to reflect on what you've done. Now, here for example, I would like to remove some of the thickness of that line and of that shadow you can see there, and I'm going to use for that the Spot Healing Brush tool and simply bring that down there. Can you see that that removes that? And you can use that anywhere. It just means that you don't have to actually blank out what you've done, but you can remove it or soften it with this tool, like that. Incidentally, If you want to make changes to the shadow, you can, of course, the actual shadow of created by the photocopy layer, you can do that too. I mean, if you think it's too much somewhere, just use the eraser tool here to reduce it a bit. Doesn't matter what brush particularly you use with it. There, for example. So you can go on fine-tuning this as much as you like. We finished our photocopying then and our tweaks. So we've closed down the source layer, and what we're going to do now is add texture to it. And the approach we're going to use is essentially to remove texture in areas of thick paint and leave it in areas of thin paint. And in this occasion, I want to, where the highlighted canvas thread appears, the texture of it, it's going to be a light colour. So the first thing we want to do is load the particular patterns that we're going to use. So come up, make sure that the pattern stamp tool is active. Then come up to the pattern picker, open it up and load artist surfaces. And the one we're going to use is the canvas one in a moment. Then down in the bottom of the layers panel, click on the create new fill or adjustment layer, the round icon there. Then click pattern, and we want to choose canvas for our texture, and let's select a scale of, yeah, that'll do, about 209%, and click OK. Now, first of all, I'm going to sharpen up the texture, and to do that, I'm going to come up to filter, down to sharpen. Unsharp mask. Now here it is, we're getting a dialog box here saying, do we want to rasterize this? And we're going to click OK. It's not going to be a problem. And then we unsharp mask. I think the settings of 54 for the amount, radius 2.4, 0 for the threshold, and click OK. Now I want to invert the value of this, so come up to image, adjustments, and invert. To see our texture in the way we want to see it, we need to change the blend mode to color dodge, and the opacity of that layer down to something like 50, maybe 48%. That's okay. And we'll use the eraser tool now to remove canvas texture appearing in areas of thick paint. I've upped the opacity of the pattern fill layer to 72, so we can clear see better where the actual texture is. And let's come in a bit. Now here. Going to increase the size of that. And here we're just removing it carefully. What we're imagining is that, and it's an inexact science this, but what we're imagining is that these are areas of thick paint which simply will not have much canvas texture showing through, and we can remove it easily because we've rasterized this particular fill layer or this pattern layer. I'm using an opacity here of about 74%. That seems reasonable. Quite good to use it. Up here you can see where these are some areas of paint. Quite thick. Exactly where you do this will obviously depend on where your thicker paint is appearing on your picture. So you can just use your imagination for this, really. Okay, well, I'll come back to this in a moment when I've finished. So that's it, that's our texture effect done. We might bring back the opacity to about 65, I think, so that it's just not quite so prominent. And you can, of course, sharpen this if you want, but I think that's fine for us, and I think that's it, we're finished.